Hi, I'm Molly, and this is officialcharts.com. So I am UK entry for Eurovision 2014, and that came about because I was uploading my music to a platform called BBC Introducing, which is a great platform for unsigned or undiscovered artists to upload their music, and then it potentially gets played at your local radio stations, and then from there it can get played nationally. So I just started to get some support nationally from that, which was fantastic. And and then I got an email from a guy called Guy Freeman, who is putting together this year's Eurovision entry, to ask if it was something I would consider. So after chatting with Guy about what they wanted to do, and the fact that they weren't trying to do some like novelty cheesy Eurovision act, and they wanted it to be not a household name, and it all sounded really exciting, I got to work on writing a song for it. And as a result, I wrote a song called Children of the Universe. And I never really thought they would choose it. I think I thought it was a bit risky for the BBC. But I was really happy with it. And they did choose it. So Children of the Universe will be representing the UK this year, which is great. It's a song about feeling a bit lost and worthless, and then realizing that you are everything and you are integral to everything that's happening at this present time. It's inspired by a poem by Max Ernham, and there's a paragraph in that poem that says, "You're a child of the universe, no more, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here, and whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should." Which I've always found really inspiring and uplifting if I felt a bit sort of down and a bit lost. So it's quite deep, actually. It's a bit deeper than Baking a Cake and some of the other entries that are in Eurovision. But one thing's for sure, Eurovision's going to be a good show. It's there's some real like mixed bags of acts and songs. And yeah, I'm really excited to be a part of it, actually. It's been really good fun so far. So I've been hearing all sorts of tips from people about how to win Eurovision, one of which is to not wear any shoes, which would be great, but I'm only 5'1", so actually I need all the height I can get, and therefore I plan on wearing very big heels. So yeah, I used to watch Eurovision when I was growing up. I think it's a bit of a tradition in the UK to watch Eurovision, and I remember learning the Gina G dance moves in the playground and stuff like that. But the last few years, I've not really been engaged with it too much for one reason or another. So it's a real surprise that I am going to be the entry. But I am so happy about it. The Eurovision community has been incredible. They're so positive, just really supportive. And I've just found the whole thing to be this like incredible journey so far. So I'm glad that I'm representing the UK. So thanks for the opportunity, and I hope I do everyone proud. So I have a secret pop past, apparently, although not that secret because it's all over the internet. I wrote a song called Raindrops, which was then collaborated with a dance track called Encore une fois, with a producer called Sash, or a DJ called Sash. And we did really well with that. It was top 10 in the UK, and I got to travel the world a bit, and loved that whole time. I was in a dance group or collective called Stunt. But, you know, to be honest, the whole thing didn't really feel that genuine to me and sincere, and I had to make a conscious choice to walk away from it. And the last few years I've been working really hard on just staying true to myself and to the music that I want to be doing, and it feels like the right thing. So one thing I'm really grateful for is the fact that I don't feel like I've compromised that in any way by doing Eurovision, which is surprising. It's not what I would imagine myself saying right now, but it's the truth. So it's been a journey and a half to get to this point, and you never know where life's going to take you, I guess. But so far I'm enjoying my journey, so we'll see.